Praise God. Hello, family. 7 years ago, I moved into a house with beautiful flowers in front. The previous owner was in charge of the gardens, although he passed away. So I couldn't ask him what the name of these flowers are. These flowers became my favorite flower as I saw them as I went out and I came into my house. I would love to watch them bloom, and every so often I would cut the flower off, put it in my hair, or put it in a cup and take it to my room just to look at or smell. And so as time went on, I asked people in my family if they knew the name. They didn't know. I went online, couldn't find a thing. I found flowers that looked like this particular flower, but they weren't that thing, you know, they weren't it, you know. So every time I looked online, couldn't find a thing, couldn't even find a bright image of these flowers right outside my house. I went on different blog websites and gardening YouTube channels and things like that, but after a while you get bored with all that stuff, because I'm not a gardener, but I do love nature and pretty flowers and clouds. Man, do I admire clouds. But over the years, as I started hearing the voice of God, the Lord would use these flowers to teach me patience. He would say things like, look at these flowers, look how they grow, and look how they're growing. He said, this is how you will grow, like these flowers, blooming in seasons. Well, no, sorry, I'm not saying, I'm saying that wrong. He said, you will be preparing to bloom. And all these seasons will pass. And then that one and final season, you'll be beautiful and prepared for everything that comes your way. And you'd always say things like that. And it just got me interested in these beautiful flowers. Okay? Still had no idea what they were called. 5 months ago, actually. Let's just skip forward to 5 months. I was walking to work, actually, and a man walks by me with a bushload of flowers. He drops one. Now, I don't mention it to him because, you know, he didn't seem like he minded much. And so I follow him and I pick it up, and guess what the flower is? Yes, the flower, the same kind of flower that grows outside of my house and in other parts of my neighborhood. I just smile and I say, God, you're so funny and I love you. I was having a pretty bad day and I feel like God was letting me know that he was around and to be patient and that he loves me because he knows these are my favorite flowers. So I wanted to return the kindness. So I took out a paper and I wrote something like, Have an awesome day. And I put the flower on a bench. And it was a public transportation bus stop bench. And so whoever needed to ride the bus, I would hope that they would see the note and the flower and have an extra pip in their day. You know, kind of like spreading the love. And I made sure to write praise God to let them know I was a Christian. That, you know, they know that God's looking out for them. So, guess what? Today, I found out what the name of the flower is. So, God told me, honey, why don't you look up flowers? And I said, okay. So, I looked up flowers on Google Images. You know, flowers just pop up. They look pretty. Everybody likes pretty things. And he said, look up the state flower of Washington. And I said, okay. And I did, and guess what the flower was? The same flower that grows outside of my house is our state flower, because I live in Washington State. Well, my state flower. And I was so beside myself. I thought, how could I be so foolish? You would think that would be the first thing I would look. I looked online everywhere, but no. And this flower is called Rhododendron's Macrophyllum. Took me a long time to learn how to say it right. Rhododendron Macrophyllum. And they are so, so beautiful. One of the reasons why God showed me the name is to declare to me, because the time of my life right now are new beginnings. You know, there's a lot of new beginnings. And He's letting me know the name of the flower because He's saying that I'm ready. I'm ready for something that He's been preparing me for. I'm not sure of what, but He's saying that I'm ready and that I'm beautiful. And, like, physically, but more spiritually. And that He's proud of me. And that all the patience and everything, that all the tests and everything paid off. That I'm ready. And I'm so excited to see what's going to happen in my future. So I'm extremely happy, and I want to share this, the happiest of moments, with you, my Christian family. So, if you guys want to know what a rhododendron macrophyllum looks like, I provided a link for you to my Pinterest. It's a playlist that I made of what the flower looks like that grows outside of my house. Because there are different types of rhododendrons. But, I'll share that link with you. And also, in the description box, you'll find a link that is connected to my Google Drive that will show you a picture of the rhododendron macrophyllum in my hair, number one. And then number two, you'll find a video, because when I picked up the rhododendron macrophyllum from the man who walked past me, when I picked it up off the ground and I put it on the bench, I Snapchatted the whole thing. And I saved Snapchat, so I'm really glad and happy about that. And I want to show you guys. And so that'll all be in my personal Google Drive, so it's 100% safe. You can download it and view the video and everything. This is a blessed day, you guys. Thank you for joining me. Praise God.